Hey guys, Vikas over here and this is VR Genius. Guys, today I are going to check out the Orange Spy Zero module. And over here, this is the module that I have received from like over in India. I ordered from inkocean.com and that comes around 1250 rupees. So this one over here is the 512 megabit version. So this comes around like 26 gram, measuring 46 × 48 mm. In width and length. So let's go through different hardware over here on the module. So on the front side we get 26 pin unpopulated GPIO header that is fully compatible with Raspberry Pi B plus module. Then coming next is the two LEDs present over here that shows activity as well as power. Over here you get the RAM chip that is for this module I am having is 512.1 version, but you can go for 256 per megabit version. That depends upon your requirement. Then coming onto the processor, there is quad core and running at around 1.2 gigahertz. Then over here you get the USB micro USB socket that is used to power it up this module, and as well as this can be used as USB OTG whenever you are not using the USB socket to power it on. Beside this, you get 13 pin GPIO header that like exposes USB microphone input, infrared input, two USB ports and audio video output. Again, if you are over here, you are not having HDMI output as compared to other SBCs. So you are solely dependent on the AV output. So if you are like interested in getting out the video out of this module, you need to expose those audio video output pins and you can use AV connector and something else. Okay. Then besides this, you get the Wi-Fi module over here connected to one Wi-Fi antenna, and that is 802.11 BG and compatible. Then you get a USB port that is full-fledged USB, and it is USB 2, okay, that you can use to connect with other devices. So this module over here doesn't implement any Bluetooth adapter, so you will not get Bluetooth connectivity. Beside this, you get the RJ45 socket that is used for Ethernet connectivity and all, and it supports 1000 Mbps connection. And this module again supports power over Ethernet. So if you are running home automation system that is using PoE, you can definitely use it. But by default, this module is inactive in terms of PoE. So you need to solder pairs the R29 and R358. Okay. And again, this PoE over here is totally supported for 5 volt only. So if you are running higher voltages, you need to use buck converters for that. And again, that can be used between R29 and R358 pads, solder pads. So for details, you can definitely go through documents on the Orange Spy website, and that will give you a detail like how to connect and all. Then over here, you get one debug port that is having RX, TX and ground. So behind like in backside of this module, we get one micro SD card socket and one SPI flash. So this module which I got actually has a populated SPI flash that is of 2 MB, but if you are onto earlier modules or old modules will not be having this populated. Okay. So that's all with the overall hardware over here. For detailed performance and all, I'll be publishing a separate video, the performance comparison between this module and as well as the Raspberry Pi Zero module. I'll have a detailed comparison between these two, so stay tuned for that. Hope in near future I'll be coming with other videos around this module, like how to use different aspects of this module, programming it by using Java or Python and interacting with different peripherals. That's all for today. Thank you guys, thanks for watching. If you have liked this video, please hit the thumbs up button, and you can definitely subscribe to my channel for latest updates. So see you next time with my next video. Thank you guys.